we'd like to basically design a torch that has meaning to Indiana, so it's kind of representative of the Indiana state flag, as well as kind of shows the technology. We're building sort of a high-tech torch. It's going to be the first of its kind.
So the main torch project is just to bring kind of awareness for Indiana's bicentennial year and to have like a unifying celebration for the state.
We're making the torch very technical. We're going to have a little chip inside that's going to do a couple of things. It's going to, one, run the safety system.
The main thing we were working on is a way to cut off the flame if we needed to. So the electrical engineers had basically nailed down a way for the torch to know when it was past 45 degrees, so that if someone fell while they were carrying the torch, there'd be an automatic way to get rid of the flame.
Also, we're using the chip to track the position of the torch in real time using a little GPS sensor. And that way, people from around the state can view the progress of the torch as it makes its journey through Indiana.
We've done some research about each individual of the 92 counties in Indiana on the environmental initiatives that have been taken in those counties. As the torch passes through each county, we're hoping that our component will be added to any educational components that will be learned in schools or anywhere else.
And then finally, the brains of the chip run a camera that will take pictures, like kind of like selfies, I guess, of the torchbearer or whatever he wants to take pictures of while he's on the torch route. And those will be automatically uploaded to the server, where then they can be kind of filtered through and then put on social media or other websites.
We've had as a goal to have the fuel produced as much as possible here in Indiana by using biofuels that are grown from crops produced in Indiana. E85, we've sort of honed in on as a particularly good fuel because of its wide availability across the state. Burns so cleanly that the flame can be, under some conditions, difficult to see from a distance. And so the students have been looking at developing additives that we can add to the fuel to give it a more dramatic flame. Now, these are the sort of additives that are put in applications like fireworks that give bright, dramatic colors. Instead of making bright colored sparks, it simply changes the color of the flame to an orange or an orange-yellow color that we would expect to see.
And their torch is gonna be like a real fire and just really cool. Ours is like a kid's version of that. We want it to be safe. We need it to be also true to the design, but there's some things that are gonna vary because ours is plastic. So originally it was just kind of a thing that we were gonna give to the schools and each school is gonna have a celebration, but what they brought up today I think is really excellent. If we could get it more mass produced and then families could buy it at the celebration.
So far the design seems to work out, and although it's been difficult working with other people, it's nice to have people from all sorts of different engineering disciplines because they each know what they're good at, and it's made the torch much better than it could be if just a few people worked on it.
I mean, we're combining things like web development, we're using microcontrollers, so we're kind of using all of our skill sets and a whole lot of programming to just glue everything together to make sure that we're able to make something that works very reliably and something that just is really cool to have being made here, like at Purdue.
Sometimes when you're working in a team, everybody's integral to it, but it was really cool to come up with an idea that actually ended up being useful. And anytime you come up with an idea that actually works in practice as well as you think it's going to work in theory is really cool, because that hardly ever happens in engineering.
Well, I think this project's a really unique opportunity to learn about how Indiana has changed over the last 200 years and how we're, I guess, looking forward to the next 200 years.